Muqtada al-Sadr has emerged as one of Iraq's most influential social, political, and military figures. The cleric rose to prominence in the aftermath of the US invasion of Iraq in 2003, when he led a popular militia against US-led forces. Since then, he has played a number of roles in the war-ravaged country, from scholar to opposition leader, from self-styled reformist to political kingmaker. So who is Muqtada al-Sadr?
سأسعى بعونه تعالى وأنتم معي إلى تأسيس أكبر مقومات الدولة وهو تأسيس جيش إسلامي مطيع لمراجعه وقواته وإن شاء الله يكون هذا الجيش تحت اسم جيش الإمام المهدي عجل الله فرجاه.
He was born in 1974 to a prominent clerical family. His father, the Grand Ayatollah Muhammad Sadiq al-Sadr, and father-in-law, Grand Ayatollah Muhammad Baqir al-Sadr, formed the Sadrist movement, a religious Shia movement that focused on helping Iraq's poor communities. Both figures were murdered under the Ba'ath regime, but that didn't stop the spread of popularity for the Sadrist movement, which attracted devoted followers through its social welfare programs during the collapse of Iraq's economy under the weight of international sanctions in the 1980s and 90s. When his father was assassinated while leaving a mosque in 1999, Muqtada inherited the reins of the Sadrist movement. 4 years later, when a US invasion toppled the Ba'ath Party, he saw US occupation as the new threat to Iraq, and called on his followers to take up arms and rebel. They formed the Mahdi Army, a militia that began staging attacks on coalition forces. On the 5th of August 2004, the US administrator of Iraq declared al-Sadr an outlaw, and in response, Sadr called for a religious uprising against US forces. His militias concentrated their attacks on US troops in Najaf, a holy city for Shia Muslims. For 3 weeks, the Mahdi army engaged in fierce street fighting in the city's suburbs. A ceasefire was eventually negotiated, with the bulk of the Mahdi army fighters surrendering their weapons to US forces in exchange for amnesty from detention. But the Sadr family didn't fight only the US. They've been widely accused of mass kidnappings and the murder of thousands of civilians during Iraq's ensuing sectarian civil war. In 2007, the Mahdi army took the port city of Basra after it lay siege to British army bases in the city and held it for more than 6 months, eventually forcing British troops to withdraw. The next year, Nouri al-Maliki, then prime minister and Sadr rival, ordered the Iraqi army to retake Basra from the Mahdi army. After the city fell, Sadr fled to Iran, abandoning political life for a few years until he returned in 2011 to ally with Maliki's second government. A dispute would break out between the two again, and Sadr withdrew his support from government. With controversy following his every step, Sadr attempted to remake his image and portray himself as a non-sectarian figure, forming links with Sunni leaders. In 2014, he rebranded the Mahdi Army, renaming it the Peace Companies. It then joined several other Shia militias as part of the Hashd al-Sha'bi, or the Popular Mobilization Forces, a paramilitary force formed in response to the upsurge of Islamic State in Iraq. While al-Hashd was essential in assisting the Iraqi forces in retaking cities from IS, human rights groups accused the paramilitaries of torture, rape, and the extrajudicial killing of civilians in Sunni areas. Sadr would again withdraw his support from the government in 2016. He accused Prime Minister Haider al-Abadi's government of corruption and of failing to deliver on reforms. In 2016, he led a million-strong demonstration in Baghdad's Tahrir Square, and his followers began a pitched sit-in outside the Green Zone. In 2018, Sadr created the Sa'irun, or Moving Forward Alliance, a coalition of his newly formed Istiqama Party and the Iraqi Communist Party, as well as smaller parties and civil groups. The bloc won 54 seats in the election that year, making it the largest in parliament. With the outbreak of the 2019 mass protest movement across Baghdad and the southern regions, Sadr once again withdrew his confidence from the government and called on his bloc to boycott parliament and urged the government to resign. After months of protests, Prime Minister Adel Abdel Mahdi was forced to resign, and early elections were announced for 2021, along with a number of election reforms. Sadr now promises to crack down on corruption and to form a government free from foreign influence. Over the years, the cleric has managed many ambiguous relationships. While a student of the Shia clergy in Iran, He is open in calling for an end to Iranian influence over Iraq. He is a vocal critic of corruption and political ineptitude in government with whom he has partnered. And while he has never completely distanced himself from Shia militias, Sadr calls for state regulation on them and limits on the arms they possess.
فقد آن للشعب فقد آن للشعب أن يعيش بسلام بلا احتلال ولا إرهاب ولا ميليشيات تخطف وتروع وتنقص من هيبة الدولة.
But with his political influence growing, how will Sadr strike a balance between the many actors he's previously teamed up with, and how will Iraq fare with the cleric at its helm?